dinosaur that shoots guns, and does kung fu. I mean, hey everyone, I'm Lorenzo, and in this video, I'm going to talk about Kung Fury Street of Rage, reviewed on PC, PS4, PlayStation Vita, and on Mac. Kung Fury Streets of Rage is a tying game that doesn't abide to the norm. Instead of just trying to poorly imitate a gameplay style that we had for ages like other tying games, it becomes a game of its own. Kung Fury is a rhythm beatmap. The game has two modes, Story and Endless. In Story, I was impressed to see voice acting. I didn't expect that in a game that sells for $2. Also, there were some good jokes in too. And the game has an original story, separate to the movie. And the story is pretty good, especially considering that it's an unknown and cheap game. In gameplay, you get two buttons, one to attack what comes on your right and one for what attacks you on your left. The controls sound simple, but the gameplay is tough, just like the arcade games it tries to imitate. Once multiple enemies come at you, the press either left or right becomes harder than it sounds. You can't move or collect items, you just attack left or right. The purpose of the game, the purpose of the story is to beat waves of enemies, and at the end, you beat an arcade boss. And in Endless, you just do that but endlessly for a high score. There are also 4 playable characters, each with different moves. Also, the title is accurate. Street, singular, of Rage. Because the whole game takes place on the same street. It has day-night cycles, but still, I would have liked to see more locations. Anyway, the game is nice to play in short bursts. It doesn't offer much in content, but the gameplay, being arcade, has a lot of replay value. On the Vita, you get the same game, only less polished. Still being a pixel game by its nature, less polished doesn't mean that it looks worse, it just looks a little different. Also on the Vita, whenever there's a boss fight, the Vita has slowdowns for some reason. But no matter if you play it on PS4 or PS Vita, I recommend you to check the game out. And the difference between the PS4 and PC is that they look slightly different, I don't know, to my eyes the PC version looks a little bit shinier. But the difference between all of the versions doesn't really matter, because the game looks good on either of the consoles. As it looks and feels good on Android too. Yeah, I've played the Android and iOS version. Okay, the iOS version on my friend's phone and the Android version on my phone, and it's the same game to me. So no matter on what device you play the game on, the game will be fun and the same experience. I recommend you to check the game out. It's cheap and it's fun to play in short bursts, or when you're bored and don't know what to play, or if you want some quick 10 minutes of fun, or if you're a hardcore arcade gamer and want to show dominance with your high scores, you can do that with this game too. And it's only $2. This is a tying game well done. It turned out unique. It may not offer much, but it doesn't cost much either. And you don't feel ripped off like in other tying games. Besides, this one is fun to play,